at Albert Einstein College of Medicine, we had a lecture organized by the Rabbinical Council of America. Well, we went in, I lectured there, and then we went into the hospital, and there were patients there who were on the ventilator, who had to be checked whether they were brainstem dead, and some were, so that people had a chance to see how this is done, how the dignity of the patient is maintained, nothing is done to hurt the patient, etc. Unfortunately, those who had been opposed to the brainstem definition of death refused to come. That was one of the dramatic signs that the issue had become an agenda, not a halacha. And the agenda was to fight the brainstem death definition. How open, how transparent the battle was between myself and Rabbi Schechter and Rabbi Willig. You don't know if you have an exchange of those letters that went to every member of the RCA.
No, I don't.
Right. And after that, there was a vote of the executive committee, and based upon one, however they evaluated the facts, and Rabbi Wolfish was really, then he was executive director then, Yimi Wolfish, and he led the battle with the RCA. But most importantly, one fellow, I don't recall who it was, maybe Rabbi Wolfish, got up and said, I don't understand why there's a issue now, it's a moot point. The Rabbanus HaRosh has ruled. It is part of our policy to support the Rabbanus HaRosh. And then after that, it became policy, period. If I can sum up the published and verbal opinions of my great father-in-law, Zatzal, Rav Moshe Feinstein, he held halacha lamase, a neighbor of mine who was a Chabadnik, needed a lung transplant. Actually, at a time when they couldn't do lung transplants, so you had to do a heart-lung transplant, because they knew how to connect the heart, but they didn't know how to cut the lungs and reconnect them. She had a heart-lung transplant in Pittsburgh. After consulting with the Lubavitcher Rebbe Zatzal, who sent her to Rav Moshe, and Rav Moshe approved the heart-lung transplant, declaring the donor dead. Rabbi Feinstein wouldn't allow that kind of rationalization, that the donor could be killed in order to save the life of a Jewish patient. The opinion of Rabbi Feinstein is recorded in the Igros Moshe. There was a tshuva, a responsa, that he wrote to me. It didn't concern organ donation. It concerned when can you stop the ventilator once a patient was declared brainstem dead. And there was no issue of organ donation there. The issue was simply, can you remove the ventilator? And Feinstein said, of course. Once you can show that he's not breathing independently, then you remove the ventilator. Here we didn't have another motivation, namely to save another human life, just to bury this one. Strangely enough, one of the opponents to brainstem death determination had the lack of integrity to make a statement in print that Rabbi Feinstein's son, my brother-in-law, Rabbi David Feinstein Shlita, had said that his father never approved the brainstem death. That went around the Jewish world. And what was missing was a little integrity of someone calling Rabbi David to ask, is it so? No one did, as at least the person did not, and kept on lecturing and publishing in print. Finally, I called my brother, I said, what's going on here? He said, you know, how many times we discussed this with our father. There's no issue. He's printed it. And he wrote a letter to the opposition, which was delivered by hand. Didn't change. The following lecture at a conference, the same repetition of a canard of this lie, until Rabbi Velvet wrote a second letter, and where he stated, my father said, a person is dead if his brain doesn't allow him to breathe autonomically, even if the heart is beating. I put underlined there. That quieted down the rumor, but never received an apology or retraction from those people who spread the rumor. And there's where halacha is debased by lack of integrity. Behind all halachic decision is the absolute integrity of the decisor. Once that integrity is questioned, then the halacha is denigrated in the process.